Right, so that's the beginning bit. Alright, 3, 2, 1, action!
Yes, mademoiselle, I get you your coffee. Thank you very much. Oh, papers! You startled me! I'm in the middle of work. I've got a side little cafe along with my restaurant. Hello, papers. My name's Viola. Kiora Kwa. And today, I've got a little tweet for you. Yes, Viola is gonna be selling her restaurant very soon. How upsetting is that? But I do have to say, Viola's got to have a big, big plans for herself. I do remember those days. All the way back to Paris. Me and El Papillon doing still in a restaurant. But I suppose it was meant to be. But I will get on the track. Anyhow, enough of those depressing times. I'm Viola Criolla Cola. And I will be making myself a millionaire by running a top class restaurant. Yes. By the way, people have been emailing me asking how do you make your flaky pasta. Well, I'll tell you how to make flaky pasta. One thing's one, or first things first, should I say. Make sure your pasta is flaky pasta. Yay. So yes, I've been working on a restaurant. Hang on just a minute. Mademoiselles, I'll be with you in just a minute. Oh! Lady C, what are you doing in my cafe?
I wanna order you my drink. I like a gin and tonic.
We don't serve alcohol here.
I want a glass of vodka with a shot of your mom's ace.
That makes no sense.
Ah, Viola. Oh, Lady C, what are you doing here?
Please, no arguings, please.
Lady C, I've had enough of your house. Oh, shut your mouth. I just came here to get drunk.
Could you please?
Lady C, you're nothing but a disgrace to humankind.
Please calm down.
Shut your mouth. You're nothing but a Spanish piece.
Shut your mouth, miss. Both of you, detentions. Go away. Before I tell your mummies.
Okay, I'm sorry, Viola. I'm sorry too, you douchebag.
Spanky piece of shit.
Naughties! Naughty, naughty, naughty! Bye, people!
Welcome to my private sanctuary. I apologize for the last time we met. A lot of things have happened since then. I remember the good times.
What sort of noises?
Try again. I might put the bloopers at the end of this. Welcome.
What
right,
now?
Here we go. Right, here we go. 3, 2, 1.
Welcome, peoples. to my private sanctuary. I apologize for the last time that we met. I had a few flaws that I need to iron out. I apologize for the noise in the back. My boys are outside at the moment beating some peasant. Very, very hard. Colombian tobacco. The finest in the West Virginia. So yes, I apologize for last time when you heard my voice was very crackly. I was unaware of how this technology works. And apparently a man called Dean Johnson says that for being a secret drug lord, you shouldn't put yourself on YouTube. That is the genius of it. I'm in a location no people can track. My IP address is hidden so no one can track me down. I'm sort of rubbing this in the cop's face. And as I said...
Hey, Papa, the chef fixed your hot cocoa for you. You know, with the marshmallows and the cream and the chocolate and the shape of the smiley face on top. You know, you always have it.
That must have been for another person.
I'll go tell Jeff for you, Papa. No. He's trying to be intimidating. Get rid of it. Go. No, I don't want one. Okay, bring it up later.
Has the problem been fixed?
Yes, Papa. It's all good now.
Alright. Anyhow, what I would like to say is I'd like to address everyone. Because you may not have heard me the first time. If you cross my family, my little diamond of a daughter, Lady Patrika, or my fragile son, El Paparondo, or my favorite child, I told you not to smile when doing these things. Sorry. We're supposed to be intimidating. Women. As I was saying, they're never gonna know our names. But we have got no aliases now. We found a friend who's been uploading things on Twitter about us, and someone's given us some really catchy nicknames. Apparently, my name is Antonio Andradas. But you can just call me Antonio. What did they call you? They called you something to do with a wolf or something like a jaguar.
They call me Puma, Papa.
Puma. So Antonio and Puma, we're at the top of our family. Where are these people at home? How much money we made today?
Today, can we just say for me, you know, midday, I forgot to do the accounts at 11. So I'll have to do that later, but, you know, since about 12. Well, we got the $3 million from Roscoe, and then we got the $7 million from the New Jersey, and then, yeah, I really don't know, Papa. I'm sorry.
We made a lot of money. That is the most important thing. So yes, if anyone hurts the feelings of Lady Paprika and Paparondo, they will have me to answer for. But before that, Puma will be dealing with you. And trust me, when you meet Puma in a black alley, you'll wish you'll never been born. Till next time, you ingrated people, tell them farewell.
Adios, amigos.
Come on, there's gotta be something on television. Nah, I don't wanna watch that. Get away, stupid truck. Ready, beach. Now go. Oh, Jail Marmalade's still doing that crap. How long is she going to be doing that for, anyway? How long have you been on this channel for? Snipe. So time again. Slowly see Shan. Slowly see with the breath of wind. It's been quite a hectic week. You know, I've got a cough. Anyway, I've got to keep my volume under control because apparently the microphone can't pick me up that well because it's a sacred crate. So yes, my breath say hello. So, you want the old lady to see bake? Well, you're gonna have her in a hurry. So, I've got some things to point out. I've got things to talk about today. Let me just open up the notepad because I can't remember them. Turn that music down. That's bad. So, right, got some things to talk about. Got a sacred chair to give away. Got some tapes. And I've also got something to talk about my show. So yes. So you see how much? Ow! Ready bake. So let's get this show scoot up and live. Does this chair have to creak constantly? It sounds like my bait. Look at that sheet. So, I'm going to set it up for this. Stop creaking. You creaking. Piece of sheet. So, there we go. So, hair in the mouth. Jesus Christ on a goddamn bank. So today, we got sacred chairs and tapes, and I got to talk about something else and something else when I can be aged. So today, today's Lady C quote of the day, because I'm putting them back in my shell, is this. Drum roll, please. Oh, what convenient sound effects. You're not seeing my arms jumping up and down. Today's quote of the week, not day, because I got them messed up. Or I might make them quotes of the day whenever I can be asked to do a quote of any some sort, anything like that. Anyhow, today's quote of whatever it is, get along with you. There we go. Hope you save that because that's going to be worth several hundred pounds in the future. In Monopoly money. Oh my god, this chair is a lot worse than the one we had before. I can't get over this damn creaking thing. So anyway, today's top 5 tapes are as follows. My god, look how white I've turned into. I look like someone's just poured a whole gallon of milk all over my breasts. So yes, today's top 5 tapes are the top 5 things to do. Hang on a minute. What is going on with my throat? Need to see if I had the drink. Oh man, would you look at that? So, top 5 tapes. I'm gonna. Is anything else gonna interrupt my show? We're going with you, Harrison Ford, in your game cars. Right, today's top 5 goddamn tapes. I was going to give you 5 nice ones, but I can't be asked to give you them, so I'll save them for another day. So the top 5 tapes I'm going to give to you is how to get a girl or a man at a club. Now it's coming up to the weekend. In fact, the weekend's tomorrow. Yeah, the week ends tomorrow, would you believe that? Because theoretically, the week ends in 2 days' time. Oh, I ain't wasting that joke, honey. So yes, here are the top 5 things to pull at a nightclub. Step 1, you gotta make sure you look kinda nice. I'd suggest you take some tips from the Queen of Fashion. And the Queen of Fashion's me, if you're not guessing that. So, what I suggest you do, is you know some women like to look naturally beautiful, naturally healthy. They like to have their normal size breasts, their beautiful brown, brunette, blonde hair, all that crap. And they like to wear those nice dresses. Well, scratch that. You want to go and get yourself an appointment, getting your breasts enhanced. Get your breasts 5 times their normal size that you would normally never do. Next, you need to get some bleach and some felt-tip paint. Melt the little, what are they called? The filter bits inside the felt-tip pans, we're going to call them that, and chuck them in a bottle filled with bleach. Shake it around, put it in your sink, make sure the plug is in there, otherwise you just wasted some perfectly good bleach. And just dunk your head in there and away you go, you get stupid abstract colors like these. I didn't do that. Okay. I heard something there. Anyhow. I don't know what that was about. So, that's step one. Get your hair to look unnatural and definitely unhealthy. Two, you always think about going into that closet and thinking, what should I try on? There's a dress here I haven't worn for nearly 10 years, but I've got this nice one that looks beautiful and elegant that fits my body perfectly. Well, throw that one in the trash and wear the one you haven't worn for 10 years. Now, you're trying to put the dress on, but you're getting a big cord up here trying to fit it around your waist. So here's what I suggest you do. Get some of that silver tape, you know, the ones the DIY men use. Start about there and start wrapping it around, sometimes overlapping some of the flaps so you make sure your waist is about as skinny as my wrist. Put your dress on and away you go. Just make sure you don't eat or breathe while you're at the nightclub, because it might make you suffocate. So, state three, this is a very important state. There's a hair sticking out of my mouth. I apologize for my throat today. For some reason, my antihistamines aren't kicking in. Get out of my mouth. So, state three. You gotta know how much money you're gonna take. Now sometimes when you feel good about earning your paycheck, you sometimes put about 30 to 50 pounds aside for drinks. Scrap that. Forget paying your bills and risk going to court and take out 10 grand. Maybe take out a loan as well, because the night's not gonna be over after 50 pounds worth of drinks. So, here's what the drinks I suggest you have. You have to buy only Jack Daniel's gin and tonic. Need some nice new Skittles vodka that they've just brought out, Zambuca, maybe an extra bit of Jack Daniel's and Coke, also Smirnoff WKD, and also 10 glasses of rum, 5 glasses of wine, and topping it off with white spirits that haven't been touched. I've just spilled tea down my breasts. Oh my god. My lipstick's running. I hope you're jotting these down, by the way. The weekend's tomorrow. My bra is not big enough to contain my mamas. So, there are the 3 tips so far. We still got 2 more to go. So, you look elegant. You got your abstract, normal, strange, colored, unnormal hair. And you've also got 10 grand to buy every drink you can possibly get your lips around. So next one, number 4, you gotta have a keen eye around the club, or the pub, whatever you're going to. You look around and you see a young man who's alone standing at the bar. So this is what you do. You go up to him and say, instead of saying, do you want me to buy you a drink? And by the way, my name's Lady Say. How are you? This is what you ask. Mister, hey, turn around. I'm going to unzip my buttons in a minute. I want you to insert your manhood in my womanly derriere. And things should go smoothly from there.
Now, step 5 isn't actually following on from step 4. Step 5 is an alternative option if step 4 fails. Let me take a sip out of my drink. Yes. Step 5, you gotta make sure that if he denies, gotta shake with you on the desk, or the bar, or whatever it's called, you ask the barman, or woman, whichever is working, and slip a 20-pound note down their pants. Now this is sort of like a bribe. You whisper in the barman or woman's ear, whichever it may be, and tell them, I want you to make sure he gets drunk. I want you to spike all his drinks and maybe give him liver poisoning just to top it off. So after you give him liver poisoning, you just watch him galloping them all down. And when he's drunk, feels like falling down, you carry him home tonight. Wasn't that a lyric from a song? Meh. So yes, and then you take him home, and there you have it. Maybe just down some Scottish whiskey and some other crap like that to make sure he's pretty much incapacitated. Woo! I need some throat lozenges for that. And I know the perfect thing. I don't have lozenges, but I've got the next big thing. Hey, thanks. I'll be with you in just a minute. Dean Johnson apparently isn't happy, saying I'm not acting like my normal self. And Dean Johnson can go lick my ass. Right. I don't think Dean Johnson acting himself. He never used to make cakes this much, and now all of a sudden he's got work. He's changing into a completely different man. I hardly know him anymore. Let me get myself comfortable. And again, apologize if video quality is great. I gotta sit at this distance to make sure the microphone doesn't go all crackly like. Okay. Right. I've got some fan mail coming up soon to read. I don't know why I'm smiling. Apparently, on my Twitter account, which you can't find at the moment because only celebrities are allowed and only top-notch VIP people can add, lots of people have been inquiring possibly about the length of my shows, why they're longer, will I be having my own time alone, what's happening with my music and film career, and so many other questions, especially about my child that no one's seen since I've given birth to it. So I'll be going through some fan mail in a minute. So, secret share time, secret share, lime and pain. Today's secret share, this is a very, very dark secret I've not shared since I was 2.5 years old. So, don't tell anybody. Even though this is on YouTube at the moment and the whole world is watching, but aside from that, don't tell anyone. Right. My secret share is, I used to be a lesbian. There we go, take that. Fooled you. No. My secret share is when I was 2.5 years old, there was a guy that I used to like. He used to hang out at all the clubs, and we used to smoke spliffs. I wanted to get his number. So, I got my little TomTom, Blackberry, whatever it's called, and I got his number, we text, we hanged out, and then one day, we're fooling around at the park, like 2-year-olds do, you know, all the youths today are doing all these crazy things, and he was in trouble by the police because he stole 18 grand's worth of televisions from the Sony store. He had them staged in his attic. 2-year-olds today. Anyhow, so whilst we're hanging at the park, a police car comes around the corner, but I don't think it was looking for him. Came around the corner and startled him, and he pushed me, and I landed on a bench without a bit of metal sticking out from the ground. The bit of metal went up my ass. So I had to go to the doctor's, and I had to have a new AS implanted. My butt is actually made of stainless steel that can inflate when I want to make my butt bigger than the Empire State. Would you believe that? So yes, that's my sacred chair. So, next thing's next. For some reason, Facebook isn't actually working at the moment. Oh my god. I want to raise my comments. For some reason, the internet ain't loading Facebook. And I want to read my Facebook comments. Alright, once Facebook loads, I'm going to do something a little bit special. Oh no, Facebook's loaded now. Right. Right, here we go. This looks like a status for me. Sex is a sensation caused by a temptation. A guy sticks his location in a girl's destination to increase the population of the next generation. Do you get my explanation or do you need a demonstration? Well, that sounds like me all over. Lynn's put up a picture of a house that looks like it's got shark eyes and a big mouth. The original is 8. Right. Time to read my wall. Right, here we go. Now, is it not going to read them? Alright, Alice has commented on my timeline and my wall post. Alright, Alice has put, Google says you're a dirty beach. Is that your head or did your neck throw up? You said, said man. Also, she says, is that a banana in your pants or are you just excited to see me? First of all, Alice cared. We all know that the neck and the head throwing up thing David said, so you stole that off mine. In addition, David also said about the banana in your pants at the cinema. You can't think of anything on your own. You dirty trade. Time for some fame, man. Snap, 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 snap. Every time I like to look around. Right, the first one comes from us from Stacey. She says, hey, Lady C, I love you so much. I was wondering if you'd be interested in adding another segment to your show where you play pranks on the other ROM characters. That sounds like a genius idea right there. I'll be playing pranks on that Papa Rondo, putting something in his drinks. Not the kind of things that you're thinking of, though, like you, Dean Johnson, you dirty-minded piece of crap. The next one comes to us from Derek. What a strange name is that? Lady C, I never once watched one of your shows without laughing my butt off. It shows your great talent. Well, thank you. Oh, and I have a question. If you could only eat one sandwich before you die, what would it be? It would be nothing more than a lesbian sandwich. And from Mr. X, kind of name is they? Lady C, I stole one of my sister's Barbie dolls and have modeled it to look exactly like you. And I have it in my bed each night and imagine stroking your hair. Believe what I just read there. A Barbie doll. Alright, right, Lady C, come on. Deep breath, man. Mr. Akes, sounds like you need some Mr. Sakes. Playing with Barbie dolls. Strange man. So, that seems to be all things I've covered in my show. Right. Get off my trousers now, Sage Rage. Right. God's sake, my throat feels like a packet of sandpaper rubbing against a bear's ass. Right. Right, coming up to a close now. I got some things, last thing, minute things I want to talk about, like the thing earlier on. I said that I got something big to get off my chest and it ain't my breasts. Hang on a minute, would you look at that? Look who's just walking up the stairs. It's none other than Alice Kerr. She smells like trash. Anything you're looking at, strange woman? By the way, bananas grow from the ground and potatoes come out of your mouth. So, I have to say, I'm going to be in a musical very soon called David Joseph's Technicolor and Mason Dreamcoat and the... or something like that. I'll be playing the role of Queen Pharaoh. Queen Lady Say. That show's now going to be reaching a 5-star rating now that I'm in it. Without me, the show wouldn't even be watched. We all know you like watching me. By the way, I'd like to remind you, 1st of August is my birthday. I'll be looking forward to that. You say it for free. I expect some lovely birthday messages. Hang on a minute. I expect some lovely birthday messages from each and every one of it, but I gotta go say hello to my number one fan. She's at the top of the stairs. Would you look at that? There's my number one fan standing at the top of my stairs. Look at that. Right. Let's get this show on the road. Even though we're already near the end of it. So yes. Joseph and the Technicolor Amazing Dreamcoat Anna will be coming out in stores sometime next week. Or something like that. I don't even know what the hell I'm talking about. So yes. I have to say, my birthday is on the 1st of August, so I expect you to write some lovely birthday messages on my wall. In addition, I want some fan mail for my birthday. Would that be kind of fun? In addition, I would like some presents. Don't forget the presents. Anyway, that's all the time I have for the moment. Thank you very much for watching Lady C with the breast and the flesh and the rest, putting you to the test. Lady C is about to go now and bathe in a pool of her own. Wait for it. Placenta. You thought I was going to say urine. Well, actually, that's what I'm really going to be bathing in, but I didn't want to say it. Apparently, it's good for the skin. That's why my skin's all nice and smooth. The hell was that? Anyway. Unfortunately, bathing in urine does have its side effects because it makes me grow facial hair conveniently when everybody else has it. Would you believe that? So yes, Lady C with the breast and the flesh is telling you, be gone with you.